Hi guys, and welcome to
Dropkick in the Beauty,
our wrestling show that we haven't done in months.
I know, because I almost forgot that we did that opening.
Yeah. Well, today's show, we're actually going to talk about WrestleMania. It's WrestleMania season now.
Right.
And we actually went to the Rumble, and surprisingly enough, we drive 4 hours to last year WrestleMania, and we did a spotlight event.
Right.
We live here in San Antonio with the Rumble that just happened, and we didn't do nothing.
Nothing. Not
we are amazing and really on top of our
game
here. We're
caught up in the moment.
So it's WrestleMania season again, and it's a fun time. It's an awesome time.
Yeah.
Rumble disappointed, obviously, because it wasn't that you didn't get the freaking surprises.
We didn't get HBK.
We didn't get we didn't get HBK. HBK wasn't it. He just wasn't in the Rumble.
We didn't get HBK.
Okay. Didn't get Kurt Angle. No Finn Balor.
Which and then also too, we didn't get the Hardys. I thought maybe we
didn't. And we'll get into that right now. So right now, let's talk about the card real quick. Mm-hmm. As of right now, obviously the hosts are the New Day, which is really disappointing because they were red hot.
Yeah.
They were red hot last year, breaking Demolition's record. And after that, they just ain't done crap, man. They had minor feuds here and
there. They're going to fall off to obscurity, and the only thing they're going to have is their claim to fame is going to be that record.
Yeah, but what sucks about that, too, is that, I mean, I think that they're really being wasted. Kofi Kingston is one of the most freaking athletic players that they got there.
And he's stuck in that character.
Yeah, it's bad. Yeah, I had a song thing on YouTube about him looking at, like, Eddie Gordo. Or him being Eddie Gordo. Gordo, that he took his Jamaican persona from Eddie Gordo. Anyway. But anyway,
from,
so
Coco Beware.
But he's, you know, and he's delivered some really awesome freaking things, some awesome moments in the Rumble. You know,
yeah,
that's jumping always, onto the. Freaking,
that's always been his.
Yeah,
thing.
It's
like
always been.
He always does something.
That's
so he's the Shawn Michaels of Rumble right now.
And that's why it's so sad that they're like caught up in this, and now they're hosts, and they're like a freaking comedy act, and not wrestlers, because they're really good in the ring.
They're gonna go the way of the whole train.
Oh, I hope not.
Yeah, that's what they're headed to.
But instead of hose, it's cereal and ice cream?
Yeah, basically what's going to come out is that they're going to start coming to the ring. And eventually, because I'm glad at least they're still winning. But eventually they're going to start jobbing.
But they're winning against scrubs like freaking...
They're going to start jobbing. They're going to start jobbing. And then it's going to be the whole train again. It was like, we're going to have the entrance and the opening, and then their match is going to take about 15 seconds. What do they call them? Squash matches?
Squash matches.
Yeah, so they're gonna be involved in squash matches all the time. But the crowd's going to get excited to see them come out and do their booty-os thing, and they're going to beat in 15 seconds, and then they're just going to be off the screen, and that's it. So what they need to do, unfortunately, is they need to break them up.
I think so too. The only thing that sucks is that, you won't get the comedy aspect of it, or maybe you will, but it'll turn kind of similar to what the Shield is. Mm-hmm. Who would go heel in that? I would go with Big E as going heel.
I mean, that's the easy one to say him, but I would like to see Kofi go heel. Kofi's been a face for so long.
Kofi is a heel. I think it would be more believable. Actually,
he's been a face for so long, it would be perfect for him to go heel. Big E Langston is the easy one to say go heel.
But, and then can you imagine Kofi versus Rollins? I mean, that would be awesome.
I mean, just the athleticism in that match. Man, God.
So you have the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. Mm-hmm. I think this is, the fourth? Because the first one was Cesaro. The second one was Big Show. The third one last year was Baron Corbin. So this is the fourth.
This is the Scrumble.
The scrumble. Yeah. So hashtag scrumble. All right. So and then it hits the nail right on the head. Mojo Rawley, Apollo Crews, Big Show, Kurt Hawkins, who is a complete wasted freaking talent because the dude can wrestle. He's really good, and they're like just punking him all over the place.
I mean,
it sucks.
They're doing that with Nellyville too. So
Nellyville.
Who? Neville.
Nellyville's the king of the freaking cruiserweights. I mean, he's putting on stuff. He had the best match last week on Raw. He had the best match.
I don't think that, they were pushing him hard. I don't think they're pushing him as hard as they were pushing him, though.
I think his heel, ever since he turned heel, it's bringing something out of him that's a little bit more, intense. And it's showing in the ring because he had this match against Jack Gallagher. Mm-hmm. And, they tore the roof down, man. They were freaking amazing. They took the cruiserweights to another level.
It's like he is a great athlete in the ring. So it's one of those things where, if he has somebody who can match to his level, then they can do a great performance.
Well, right now he's got Austin Aries at Mania, possibly. How do you think that? Because Aries is good, too.
Well, it's one of those things where, the story gets told in the ring. So if they can come up with something great, as they can, you know, give us something great in the ring, then it's going to be something special for them. But if it's one of the ones where, like, even, how do I used to say it? Like, do you remember when there were two radio broadcasters, and Tony, he's still radio. Yeah. But anyway, sometimes by putting two great people together doesn't always make magic.
Okay.
And so it all is going to come down to what we get to see unfold in the actual ring.
The old four Lakers.
You know, putting right. together a great team doesn't always work. Andrew Siciliano and Tony Bruno. There you go.
I thought they were all right.
They were all right. But when you hear Andrew Siciliano talk about it, he was like, dude, it was like, we were supposed to be like this great broadcast. And he was like, it didn't always gel.
Yeah.
And that's what I worry sometimes by seeing, you know, two athletic guys being in a ring together, not knowing what it's going to come out to. Not seeing them in the ring together before and not knowing what I'm going to get. And it's one of those things where you're just like, I hope it's good. And on paper, it's good. But will it turn out to be as good when actual match
takes place? Pretty sure that they've had times where they do house shows. I'm pretty sure that there's because Aries just got back from an eye injury. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I know he was off for a while. But before that, I mean, I'm pretty sure they had time at NXT and, mm-hmm. and time in house shows and stuff. So you never know. But mm-hmm. I'm really looking forward to that match at Mania.
And sometimes you need that person who is not an athletic person to help sell the athleticism of the other person. So
now here's something. Mm-hmm. Here's one that I don't really agree with at all. Last night, and I don't know if you see it. Last night, Enzo Amore and Big Cass, they were going up against Cesaro and Sheamus. And you want to talk about a freaking who should be in the scrumble? I got Enzo and Cass.
Do you think Enzo and Cass is burning out, man?
I think Enzo and Cass is, and though.
I mean, besides the old
age,
dog.
The old age outlaws. Yeah. They're the new age outlaws.
When I just got through talking about being the whole train, it was like, dude, they're burning out like the road dog. Like, I mean, like the road dog and Billy Gunn did.
They have
like, they're burning out like that. And that's the reason why they had to break them up.
And you mentioned that because mm-hmm. you have one that delivers the whole thing, and mm-hmm. then you got one that says two words, only this time it's one word.
It's way too long. It's way too long. It's way too long.
I think Enzo, and you're good in the ring. He's decent in the ring, actually. Mm-hmm. But I think he's overstayed his welcome already when it comes to being on the mic and all that. I think he needs to tone it down a little bit. Yeah, pretty much. Road Dog, yeah. But you know, Road Dog was at least friggin', he was IC champ.
Yeah.
He was... You know, hardcore champ.
Hardcore champ, yeah.
So, mm-hmm. you know, at least they have so gold. Guy haven't done anything yet.
Give him some titles.
So maybe a nice little cruiserweight. Okay. Maybe put him in the cruiserweight by himself and go from there. Because honestly, I think that he's holding Big Cass back. That's mm-hmm. that's my honest opinion. I think he's holding that. Because that
Test
dude.
Test 2.0.
Yeah, Test / Edge maybe.
He's too big for Edge. Test 2.0.
Well, I said together. Flashes, okay. I mean, it's like a combination of Edge and a Test.
Okay.
Testies? Forget it. All right. 1, 2. All right. So last night on Raw,
Tested.
Enzo and Big Cass, they were fighting Cesaro and Sheamus, who are really turning into a pretty damn good tag team. And so they're fighting, right? And then Luke Gallows and freaking Anderson come out, and they interfere in the match. Mm-hmm. And they're the champs. So... What purpose do you have to interfere in a match when you should just let them beat the hell out of each other? And now Mick Foley goes and he adds a triple threat tag team match.
You just gave the purpose. That's the reason.
No. But you just gave. No, I'm talking about just the logic behind them.
But like saying like why
now
would
you
do
don't
it
even
second?
Have to get pinned. You don't have to get pinned to lose your belts.
Right.
It was a stupid move. I did not understand that.
Just for them to set up that particular storyline wasn't a great way for them.
Yeah,
to do
I don't
it.
Understand mm-hmm. what creative was thinking on that. I really don't get what they. That just didn't make any sense to me.
They wanted to. You know what? It's one of those things where, like, one, they always try to be like, oh, we're going to give them something that they don't expect because obviously the WWE fans always try to predict what's going on. So if they do something that's not expected and it doesn't always come off well when presented on screen because it's trying to be unexpected. So, I mean, in the real world, nobody would do that. But it's probably just say, hey, get out there so that way we can announce a triple threat.
Well,
do something in so we can get a triple threat.
Mm. SmackDown women's title match is on there now, and Alexa Bliss was actually kind of like getting away from everybody. Didn't want nobody. was ducking everybody. So Daniel Bryan pretty much makes it like, you know what? You don't want to fight one of them, then you're going to fight all of them. Right. So Mickie James versus Carmella versus Natalya versus Becky Lynch versus Alexa Bliss for the women's title at Mania. That's interesting.
I want Mickie James to be with.
That's interesting.
I want TJ's to be champ.
But I don't. I don't. I think that champ. You need one on ones here. You need one on ones. Now, mm-hmm. don't get me wrong. You know, all them ladies in the ring together. You know, I get it. But but from a freaking sports standpoint, mm-hmm. I would like to see her go one on one with somebody besides Becky Lynch. I would have thought that her versus Naomi, which I think could possibly still come back. I think that would have been an awesome way for Naomi to come back.
Which and my kids are a fan of Naomi.
Yeah. For her to win the title in Orlando, because she's from Orlando. So that would be awesome if she gets added to
it's
that.
It's two on the nose. I don't think they would do that in Orlando. It's two on the nose.
And then last year, you had Becky Lynch versus Charlotte versus Sasha.
Right.
Right? When mm-hmm. they were getting away from the Divas and they were going into this friggin' women's title, right? Right. Mm-hmm. Well, now it's the exact same card, except instead of Becky, it's friggin' Bayley.
Right.
And now you got the top three female ex-champs from NXT. Mm-hmm. You got the top three girls. Now right. they're headlining WrestleMania.
Right.
Why are you doing another friggin' triple threat?
Why? It's only way that they can actually get some screen or get some time for in a spotlight for these women. Why would they not? Well, I understand where you're like one-on-one matches come off better because it spotlights those two characters.
Right.
And it's more of a one because you get to say like, I beat you as opposed to I was in this match in a triple threat. You maybe something quirky happened and then I lost or, you know, you won based on, you know, I beat this person and then you jumped in and got a pin after you did something dirty. I get that particular point. But seeing that they're slowly trying to make the women's more of a showpiece to the roster as opposed since they really damaged the women wrestling division with the Divas for a long time.
Yes, they did.
They did a lot of damage with this and they're really trying to work to bring that back. And unfortunately, it's a slow process. So they have to give some time for these women to actually be on screen and triple threats are the best way that they can give everybody a main event match or give at least another person a main event without having to do two women's matches, which they don't seem that they really want to do.
Having a 4-hour show, you would think that they would actually give that time to those because if you go one on ones, I think right now Nia Jax is in the who's freaking dominant right now. She's freaking doing real good.
But if they did something like that, then are you because they don't really like to put the women late in the show?
Well, I mean,
they normally do somewhere like mid.
If you went
mid to early main event.
If you went now here's another part that sucks. First of all, like I said, Nia Jax is on a roll. Mm-hmm. Why she's not in the freaking title picture, I have no freaking idea. But having Nia Jax versus Charlotte should have been the title. Should have been the freaking match at Mania. I would have loved to see that match. It would have been an awesome match. And then maybe pre-show Dana Brooke versus, you know, Bayley or whatever.
I mean, the thing was like, their biggest names had really been Charlotte and Sasha, so.
Yeah, but they keep highlighting them on Raw.
Because
and on mediocre sell. Pay-per-views like Fastlane
they
and shit
sell.
Like that.
So they sell, that's
don't, why. They don't
it's
really,
like when Hogan and... It's back to that time. It's like they don't feel like their roster names are big enough to sell, which is why they have to rely on those two particular wrestlers, and then two, they have to do these three ways. They have to do these. They have
my
to
kind
do
of match.
These gimmick matches in order to get more spotlight on these other people. Because if you just put like the smaller names and matches together, then people kind of overlook them. They're like, oh, I don't really know them. And they don't really care too much about it. But if you throw that one person that they're trying to push into a main event match with two other wrestlers that they know, then it's a way for that person to get some interest, I guess.
What sucks about it though is, like I said before, that you know they're showcasing some pretty damn good matches on Raw, which is good, but you're taking away from the main shows that you could possibly do. So that does.
So you feel like they're wasting it on Raw, and they should put it in pay-per-views.
At some point, yes. I mean, maybe you know, with interference, with DQs, or something like that, where the story continues and then they finally end it or whatever. But they're not doing that. They're actually getting pinned. They're getting pinned clean, whether it's clean or dirty, whatever. But they're getting pinned on Raw, losing
because you know why?
Because the women's title is just switching hands left and right over and over.
You know
what? I mean, Charlotte's a 5-time champ already, and she just fucking started last year.
You know why that happens? Is because some people complain and say that a lot of times that it's a lot of teasing. It was like, you know, nobody ever wins cleanly. Nobody ever gets... So they try to sell...
But they should do that at the Big Four, to be honest with you.
All right, so...
At the Big Four. Maybe even Money in the Bank. So something like that.
All right, so you're going to have a title change every pay-per-view. Right?
No.
I mean, not a title change, but you're going to have a title match every pay-per-view. At Somebody's going to win or lose.
But then you have Night of Champions, too, which is showcases pretty much all titles.
Right.
So... Yeah, you could use, you know, maybe that's another one outside the Big Four besides Money in the Bank that could happen.
But on the actual, so on your Raws and your SmackDowns, so you're gonna say never lose a belt?
I think that maybe, you know, depends. It all depends. You know, I mean, Mankind won the freaking belt on Raw, so it all depends. You know, on the story and where you're going with it.
Okay.
You know, but the problem is, I think that they're just lack of depth. They have a lack of depth in the female spot.
No, they have depth. They just don't. They do not.
They have Sasha, Charlotte. They have
because that's all the names
Nia,
they push. That's
Nia,
all.
Bayley. And freaking
they
Dana
have plenty.
Brooke.
They have plenty of depth in NXT. They just haven't pushed them into the show.
Yeah, well, I don't know.
It's just they haven't pushed them into the show. Like, I think that Asian girl that's on NXT,
Asuka. They gotta bring her, but they can't because she's carrying the belt right now.
Exactly. It's like they have the talent.
She's carrying the brand
because they're still trying to keep that show afloat. So
exactly. But that's why I say that, you know, they need more depth. They need to stop messing around with this whole Emma gimmick that they're trying to do and bring her in because she's talented too.
So like, okay, cool, because we got Mickie James back. So do you want them to bring back some of the old wrestlers so that way they have some more depth?
No, honestly, I really don't. Yeah, I really don't, because if you really look at the Attitude Era, Hogan wasn't walking through that door.
Patino. If this is Women's Month, and this is how long this women's segment has run on.
Right. Why are we wearing pink? I don't know. But yeah, so, you know, in the Attitude Era, you didn't have Hogan coming through those doors. You didn't have, you know, all those, because they were WWE.
Okay, so you're saying at that particular time, they were forced to build up other.
Exactly. And
but they're not forced because, all right, so they're Hogan and Charlotte and Sasha right now.
For them, man. No, I would go Roman Reigns and John Cena, to be honest with you.
No, I'm not talking about, like, in general for, like, but in the women's division.
In the women's division? Yeah. Yes, because they need Paige. They need Paige bad.
Paige is not coming back anytime soon.
All right, moving on. Now, the storyline here with Kevin Owens and Jericho.
KO.
that freaking storyline is freaking awesome.
Yeah.
And what he did to Jericho on Raw was just ridiculous. But it really, Jericho sold it so well. They played off each other so well that they have, with this single match at Mania, they're freaking elevating the U.S. title.
Yeah. And that's the great thing about Jericho, is because Jericho is always, no matter what title he was fighting for, no matter if he was heel or he was face, he always sold everything that he was doing. He sold you as heel. He sold you as face. He sold, he's not fighting for world championship. He's fighting for the U.S. title. It doesn't matter. You always get interest in whatever Jericho does and whatever particular match that he's in. And being in, KO was a great performer. And it was. And I'm not sure. I'm not always a big KO on the mic person, but
he's getting better.
He has Jericho for that. He has Jericho to carry him on that one. But that's what makes this match interesting, because it's Jericho versus a great worker. So,
One match that I'm pretty curious
Jericho's
about.
Jericho's a great worker too. I don't want to take away from Jericho.
One match that I'm pretty curious about is Roman Reigns versus Undertaker. Now that was that was recently announced.
Yeah, and I heard that and I saw that and I was like,
how would you book that? Because Roman.
Okay, it's a great thing that we have not seen, but Roman Reigns is not the best before. He always needs somebody who can help him.
Like AJ, because when and AJ fought,
he needs somebody who can help really him. And Undertaker, I don't think is the best. Look, Undertaker, I mean, he's for years, 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 but he is not the person to help somebody else in a match.
How do you figure that, though? As far as carrying him?
Yes.
Or are you talking about elevating him if he loses? Because I think that Undertaker's going to lose.
Okay, think of the best Undertaker match you've seen.
Undertaker, Michaels in WrestleMania 20.
Michaels can carry anybody in a match.
Undertaker, Triple H.
Triple H can carry anybody in a match. Triple H carried Roman Reigns in a match.
That's true. Punk was good. That match was excellent.
Exactly. Undertaker has been in the ring with people who he doesn't have to carry. He will have to carry Roman Reigns.
You really think so?
Yes.
Why do you say that?
Because Roman Reigns has he has a Superman punch. I mean, he's a three-move Hogan at this point. He's really at this point. He has a great look. He has a great persona, but he is not a great wrestler.
He's gotten better.
He's gotten better, but he is not a great look. Look, as much as we love The Rock, The Rock's not a great wrestler. When The Rock wants to be technical, he can, but he chose not to be technical in his wrestling career.
True.
Can Roman Reigns be technical?
I don't know. I haven't seen it yet.
Well, you know exactly.
What? Wait a minute. I take it back. Him and AJ last year, I think.
You give me somebody who can push him.
All right, then. Never mind.
Somebody else can carry it. Give me Roman and Bob Backlund.
So Taker.
Bob Backlund would carry him.
Now, so Taker's going to, it looks like Taker is going to pass the torch. Looks like it's going to be.
He already did.
No, I mean, like, hey, man, for real this time.
He did when he lost
to Brock.
Rock.
Now, no, he just wanted the streak to end, but this is actually like, you know, I'm done. This is it.
Okay.
I think this might be his last match. I really do, honestly. Strowman is on a tear. He was, okay. they book him as a monster, mm-hmm. and then he got, like, he kind of walked with his tail between his legs when The Undertaker came out. I did not get off to that. I thought mm-hmm. that was stupid. Him being pinned clean at Fastlane by Roman Reigns was stupid. I thought that was a dumb move because you've been pushing this guy and building him up all these weeks, and then you're going to freaking soften him up by getting pinned clean.
We're going to go back to, like, how many dirty, like, wins do you want? And it's like, somebody's got to win clean.
Yeah, but you don't build a guy like, then he should have won, clean.
All right.
I think he should have won the one clean. But he's in a feud with Reigns right now. And now you got Reigns and Taker at Mania. Okay. So where would you put Braun in that? Should he be part of the triple threat? Or since everybody wants to be a triple threat right now? Or
no, because if you truly believe this is Taker's last match, then you don't make it a triple threat.
Should he be the reason why Taker loses, or should he be the reason why Roman Reigns loses?
Do you want Taker to go out on a loss?
Well, that has nothing to do with me. I'm asking you seriously. What do you think?
I don't think Taker should go out on a loss. I think he should go out on a win and then just call it there. It's like, I think all legends should go out on a win.
But do you think that Braun should have something to do with him winning?
Okay, I'm okay with that because then that helps sell Roman.
All right. This was just announced today.
All
right. And you want to talk gimmick matches? Let me tell you something right now.
The Scrumble's a gimmick match.
As much of John Cena that I'm not that big of a fan of, mm-hmm. he's been putting some damn good matches lately. The AJ style match.
John Cena, look, for as much crap as they give amazing. John Cena is a great wrestler, and he will go down as a legend in wrestling.
Absolutely. but now he's doing some pretty damn good mic work against The Miz again. So now they officially announced it today, John Cena and Nikki Bella versus The Miz and Maryse.
Okay. I'm actually excited about that match.
I don't know.
I'm excited about that match.
I think that they killed the whole John Cena persona by adding his personal life, his girlfriend. I think that was a stupid move.
I mean, it had to. It's like it transitions from Divas, or not even from Divas, from their actual individual show.
Total Bellas.
Yeah.
The Miz is doing some pretty good.
People are already watching that show, so why wouldn't they transition that into the thing?
The Miz is doing some good mic work.
Miz always does good,
right? But he's like really attacking him, and John Cena like, hey, you stole Jericho's personality, you stole Ric Flair's moves.
He stole Ric Flair's moves, but I don't think he stole Jericho's personality.
And now you're stealing Daniel Bryan's yes chance.
I don't know. I don't think he stole Jericho's. I don't think he stole Jericho's personality
in the beginning when he first came out. Maybe.
Really?
Maybe. I don't know.
Maybe he's working the whole movie.
Now he's stealing from The Rock because he's Hollywood Rock.
Yeah. We never got Hollywood Rock.
We didn't get Hollywood Rock.
When?
We got Hollywood Rock when he went against Goldberg back in 03. You remember that? Okay. Anyway, so I'm not really a fan of that match. We'll see how that one goes. Now here's
The Rock's a millionaire.
This is the one that's this is the one that's confusing. He's a WWF champ. Randy Orton wins the Royal Rumble.
Okay.
Then he says he's not gonna fight Bray Wyatt because his devotion to him.
Yeah.
Then they have the freaking another scramble, mm-hmm. and AJ wins.
Right.
Or actually, there's a controversy because AJ and Luke Harper they lose. Mm-hmm. They fall out together. Then they have a one-on-one with AJ and Harper. AJ wins. Then Orton burns down Sister Abigail's house or whatever, makes Bray cry or whatever, and now he wants to fight him for his belt now.
Right.
What the hell was the point of denouncing your damn Rumble win if you freaking, you know, if you were going to fight him anyway? That's the stupidest thing I ever heard in my life.
That is creative saying that, like, maybe we shouldn't have made him win.
Yeah, that was exactly.
That's creative saying, you know, we kind of goofed up on that. We got to fix this.
So now you have the match between AJ and him last week, and they actually fight and put on a great match. Mm-hmm. AJ is he's the best wrestler they have right now, in all honesty. That's my opinion. Mm-hmm. So now Randy wins that match, so now he's going to face Bray Wyatt at WrestleMania for the title.
Right. I mean, it's been a long time coming, so.
Right, but again, why did you denounce your win?
Forget it.
Meanwhile, they're going to potentially have AJ Styles fight Shane McMahon at WrestleMania? What kind of bullcrap is that?
Because, you know what? People love Shane.
Yeah, but that's not, you know, give me Balor versus AJ. Give me somebody against AJ. AJ deserves better than that.
You know what's funny is that I haven't kept up with Balor since he's come back. What have they done with him?
Nothing. He was hurt. He got hurt at some point.
Well, yeah, no, but since he's come back, so wait, he's not coming back till WrestleMania?
Well, he did a house show in Buffalo.
Okay.
And it was him, oh my God, him, Jericho, and Sami Zayn versus Triple H, Samoa Joe, and KO.
Okay.
So there's that dynamic.
So he's only done a house show.
He's done house.
He has not made an appearance.
He has not made an appearance.
Okay.
So potential spoiler, I don't know. In WrestleMania, I don't know. Because right now, Triple H...
But how's that a book match if he hasn't actually come back yet?
Triple H versus Seth Rollins is a possibility.
Okay, that's a good
That's point. An awesome freaking storyline. It's an awesome...
Yeah.
Why does Triple H... Next year, he's going to fight Dean Ambrose. Because he fought Roman Reigns last year.
I'm going to be the whole Shield.
He's going to be the whole Shield by myself. So, I think it's going to be a pretty decent match. Rollins looks like his knee is getting better. Mm-hmm. I think after last night's Raw, if you haven't seen it, Triple H just beat the crap out of him and would broke his knee or beat the crap out of his knee with a crutch.
When is Triple H going to stop wrestling?
I don't know. I think that they're trying to make him like the Undertaker now. But after years of burying people mm-hmm. and not wanting to get pinned by nobody, now he's trying to pay it forward, I guess, because he got pinned by Roman Reigns, mm-hmm. and now he's more than likely going to lose right. to Seth Rollins. So we'll have to see what that goes. I think that mm-hmm. I think Finn Balor interferes in that match one way or another, and there's a new on Triple H's side, a new faction is born with Balor, Joe, and freaking Owens as the former NXT champs. So we'll see how...
That would be interesting, to
NXT
be
connection. I don't know. What do you think?
That would actually be interesting.
That'd be cool, right? That'd
be yeah, good. It would be.
Because the rumor is that Triple H action.
Called?
I don't know. NXT thugs. I don't know. All right.
Next thugs.
Next thugs. So last pay-per-view Fastlane, you had Kevin Owens versus Goldberg. I really thought it was going to last like a lot longer, but it was... Like
dude, it's Goldberg.
It lasted as fast as me and my teenage years.
It's Goldberg.
So Goldberg squashes him after an interference by Jericho.
Right.
Or not interference, but a distraction by Jericho. And he beats KO. They had already booked a match for Goldberg versus Lesnar 3 right. in WrestleMania. Did it need the freaking the Universal title?
What? Okay, look. What else are you going to have him do?
Don't you think that...
Just have the match without the title.
But don't you think... Well, their names. Just their names by themselves okay. is enough. But I'm talking about, wouldn't it be better for Jericho Owens
it's one
for
of
the Universal title?
It's one of those things, if they don't do something with him until then people are going to be like, well, why isn't he fighting for something?
Well, right now he's going to get booked to lose. Goldberg's going to get booked to lose. And the match, from what I've read from the dirt cheats, is that it's going to be freaking fast. It's going to be a fast match at the end.
Really?
And that Brock Lesnar's going to win the title.
So they can have a rubber match. Oh, that ain't a rubber
no,
match.
No, this
that
is it. This match. Is the rubber match coming up at Mania.
So he's going to go down 2-1?
Yeah.
They would give him another match.
I don't know. But because he's going to be out for a while. Lesnar has the JR.
No, they'll do a comeback match.
JR was thinking of Lesnar having the whole year with the mat, with the belt.
They'll give him some time off with his family. He'll come back and he'll do another match. It doesn't make any sense to go 2-1. I'm winning. Who cares? I went out on a loss. I still have the record on you.
And then again, Lesnar reigns WrestleMania 34.
I mean, I can see him winning. That's not a problem. But I can't see Goldberg saying like, oh, well, I can't see them letting... For somebody who's not going to come back, we already dealt with the fact that like, oh, you have that over me. We're still going to walk away with him saying like, oh, you have that over me. You have two wins over me?
Well, it'd be 2-2, I think, wouldn't it? I think it'd be, right now it's 2-3-1, isn't it? No, it's 2-1.
It's 2-1.
It's 2-1. It would be tied 2-2. Because WrestleMania 20 I think Goldberg won that. That's 1.
Goldberg is, I thought it was 2-0.
No, you're right, it is 2-0.
It's 2-0.
Yeah, you're right.
So even if Brock wins this one, it would just be 2-1.
It'd be 2-1. He still
He doesn't walk away. I say, like, I still beat you.
I beat you 2-1.
I beat you 2-1. Who cares if you won the last one?
Yeah. Took your cookies.
So that's what I said. Like, I can't understand why they would leave it at that.
Well, as of right
they
now,
they would at least have to get it to a tie.
Unless you see something happening at SummerSlam. But I think, and now let me talk to you about that real quick. Not SummerSlam, but when they brought Goldberg back,
mm-hmm.
you know, for the WWE game, that was October.
Right.
So he does the interview at ESPN. He talks about, I mean, he just outright said, I don't owe Brock Lesnar a rematch. And in my head, like, well, who asked you about Brock Lesnar? Nobody even asked you about it. Anyway.
Oh, you brought up Brock Lesnar? Yeah, I don't owe him a rematch. Dude, so, we were talking about ice cream.
Well, Brock Lesnar ice cream. I lick. All right. So now they go to Survivor Series. They have that match. And it's over in whatever, a minute, whatever. Yeah. About as long as Punk's fight.
Yeah, there you go.
And
about as long as Punk's fight.
And then they go to Royal Rumble. He eliminates him. And then he wins the title. And I think once he won the title, once Goldberg beat Kevin Owens at Fastlane, I think now, because now the crowd is starting to boo him. They are really starting to boo him. And the people in Detroit, I think they were in Detroit last night. Your hometown. Yeah. They were cheering for Lesnar and booing, Goldberg. So
that's because
I think it's split half-half.
But WWE fans don't like somebody to be on top for too long.
You think so?
No, it's always been proven. They hate people be on top for too long.
I thought that it would be more because, you know,
Because he came and then now they're going to make him champion.
They're forcing.
Kind of like the Roman Reigns thing.
Yes, exactly. Okay. Exactly.
And it's like, oh, you're already champ. I mean, but it was for the U.S. title. Come on.
No.
Hey, who can't win that one?
Well,
if you're going to sell him as a main eventer, like against Brock. But to say that he can't win it?
But the Universal title, I mean, you know.
To say he can't win it?
All right. I don't like what they're doing.
All right, so it's one of those things. We're going to go old school here. It's kind of like to say, like, when Stone Cold was U.S. champ. Or, IC champ. When he was IC champ.
Okay.
And he was like, yeah, I got bigger and better things to do.
And he threw in the water.
Yeah, because that's how he's like, I don't give a shit about this title. And that's how Goldberg feels about this title. And that's the way it's like, if you build him as like, he is top tier, if he fights a champion in a lower tier,
he's walking in as champion. He shouldn't have beat
you
Kevin.
You put him against the top guy. Never mind. He's beat the top guy. He can't beat Kevin Owens?
No, he should not have beaten Kevin Owens.
Can Kevin Owens beat Brock? No. But Brock has been beat by Goldberg, so you're gonna say Kevin Owens can beat Goldberg? So you just what you're saying is that they should just not have made it a title match. They should have just made it a regular match, and I get it. But they had to give him something to do.
So that
because means, they, you know why? Because they want to have him come out and they want to have him do this.
I guess
they want to have him do this, and they want to
sell this. They want to sell the plates. They want to sell the
Goldberg on the
Goldberg plates.
They got to give him a belt.
Oh man!
If you don't give him a belt, you can't sell the replica belts. You can't sell. You can't have him come out and do all this.
Bring Goldberg back. Either way, I don't.
It helps the merchandising.
I'm curious to see how Mania is gonna go. I think all of us are. One of the bright spots for me is that Kurt Angle is a freaking Hall of Famer. That's freaking awesome.
I don't know why they can't get Kurt Angle back on the show.
Well, I'm pretty sure that they will.
I mean, that's been a rumor for a long time, and it still ain't happened. So.
And real quick, just to touch up on something, Alberto Del Rio made his freaking debut at TNA. His first match, he wins the title. He beats Bobby Lashley.
I mean, it's Bobby Lashley.
That's horrible.
It's Bobby Lashley.
And last but not least, it's possible that Matt Hardy and Jeff Hardy could use
version one.
If they sign with WWE, they might have to go to their freaking original Extreme personas, because
they're
Impact
too old for that.
Because Impact will not let them use the freaking broken Matt Hardy or whatever.
People are still gonna do it.
Listen, because they own the name or whatever, even though it's his idea. Mm-hmm. It was completely his idea, completely brand new. Because
he sold it though.
I have no idea, but they said that he can't use it unless WWE gives them a portion of the merchandise sales.
He probably sold it to him.
It will not freaking happen. I'm telling you right now.
No, they're not. They're just gonna go back to Jeff Hardy and Matt Hardy.
And that's gonna suck. It's gonna disappoint the fans everywhere. No. So I hope that they get back into the...
People are gonna be doing broke. Delete. Delete. Delete.
Oh, man. Anyway.
People are gonna be doing that in the stands, or they're gonna be doing V1. They're gonna be like, look, dude, we already know who he is.
Right, but it just sucks that he can't be that, because, I mean, think about it. Broken Matt Hardy versus Undertaker, that'd be awesome. I think that'd be cool. I'd like to see the Hardys versus Enzo and Cass so they can beat the crap out of them.
I would like to see Edge and Matt Hardy again.
Oh, man. So tell us what you think about who or what should be on the WrestleMania card, and who would you bring back, Nostalgia Act? I'd bring back, like...
Angle.
And who else?
We were saying Matt Hardy, Matt and Jeff. You know what? You know, we were talking about like how now they're actually going back to the old days where they're putting athletes at the forefront.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, give me Rob Van Dam.
Rob Van Dam. Well, I mean, he can be in a legend contract. I'm pretty sure he can do something. Maybe.
Yeah, cool. I mean, he was great working the ring, and it was like we talk about athleticism. I mean, like him and Nellyville.
Oh, man.
I refuse to call him Neville. Nellyville.
Yes! Take us home.
All right, so we're trying to get better with this show.
I don't think it's working.
We're trying it, not overall as far as how well we do the show, because, I mean, look, this is one of the shows where we really just get to talk. We don't have to talk about, like, you know, what's new.
I have no notes.
We really just get to talk.
No cards.
But we don't do this show enough. And what's funny is that, you know, this is probably, like, the biggest impact in our life besides movies is wrestling. And we don't do this show enough.
And so. Surprisingly enough, this is actually show three.
Yes, it's show three.
It's show three.
It's one of the things where, so, like, if you guys want to see this show more often, let us know in the comments.
If you don't want to see it, let us know.
Let us know in the comments, because we'll just stop doing it. But let us know, because we're trying to figure out, like, where we're at in the format on this. If we want to do this after pay-per-views, we want to follow up after pay-per-views. I don't think we have time to do it, you know, per Monday night events. Mm-hmm. But maybe we can do it monthly, or maybe, you know, like I said, with before a pay-per-view. Let us know how you guys want us to do it, so that way we can recap or maybe just talk about what's upcoming news in wrestling. But make sure you subscribe and comment.
And give us your thoughts. Give us your thoughts on where the hell is creative going with this? And do they need new writers? Do the brothers over there at whatculture.com need to freaking just invade WWE and be the freaking... and be the writers in there.
Vince has, like, final say on all the storylines anyway. So if he wants somebody to lose a match.
Adam,
like,
can you please just duct tape McMahon and take over Raw?
You're a fire.
Oh, man. For Aspen in the back, I'm Manny.
It's Aaron.
And we'll see you next week or next month or next year.
Just look at the playlist.
We'll see you soon.
Showing up, so wearing the same clothes, I don't care, because I'm freaking like that. Because you know what? When you're chocolate salsa, baby, you can freaking wear, you can wear whatever the hell you want, baby. You go over there and you freaking take it to them all day with freaking being nude. I put brothers in the freaking crack of my ass and freaking give them headlocks all freaking day. I freaking give them a freaking, I put my freaking wiener on their freaking necks and squeeze them like freaking Damien for Jake the Snake back in the day. No?